Today on Animal Outtakes...
Stop roasting the dog!
Meet a team of dogs that are fighting crime. We show you how these amazing animals train, from chasing down suspects... to diving after deviants. All to keep communities safe. Hello and welcome to Animal Outtakes. I'm your host, Marsha Panuce. Today we're meeting some incredible dogs who work hard to protect communities across the country. We're talking about police canines, and in today's episode, we're learning about their training and just what it takes to be successful. There's a lot to cover, so let's get started.
Sarasota Police Canine, come on up to the dog!
This is Hickson.
Sarasota Police Canine, come on up to the dog!
Hickson is a police canine working with the Sarasota, Florida Police Department. He and his handler, Officer Sean Gleason, are searching for bad guys. But more on that in a minute. Hickson is one of three dogs that are part of the department's canine unit. There's also Cody, with Officer Nick Dominus, and Bronson, alongside Officer Jake Nelson. When these teams go to work, it's the bad guys who pay the price. It takes a special kind of dog to take on this tough job.
What type of dogs are considered for the police and working dogs?
Typically, it's German Shepherds or Belgian Malinois. We have two German Shepherds right now, and I have a Belgian Malinois.
What is the outstanding quality that these two dogs possess that make them so valuable to you?
The outstanding quality for them is that they're very good at everything we need them to do. They're not the best at any one thing, such as a bloodhound would be a better tracker, but he's not going to catch somebody. We look for dogs that have an extremely high toy drive. And because if they have a high toy drive, you can train them to do anything because all they care about is getting their toy.
What about temperament? There is a misconception that these dogs really can't be blended in to the normalcy of life, that they are just working dogs, they're attack dogs, and period, that's all they do.
We try to avoid dogs like that because we like to be able to bring our dogs out in the public, let kids pet them. You know, I take my dog into schools. So we look for dogs that have a nice personality, that like people, but they can basically turn it on and off.
On the job, it's a 12-hour shift for these courageous canines. The handler's vehicles are outfitted with a special kennel designed to keep the dogs comfortable and, more importantly, safe.
They're very safe when they're in the car. We get a lot of questions when we're out in the public. Our cars are equipped with a heat alarm. If something were to happen and the car stalled or shut off or something while we're not in the car, the alarm will sound, the back windows roll down, and a fan comes on to blow all the hot air out of the vehicle.
And at the end of the night, it's time to head home with their partners.
You take them home.
We do take them home, yes. It's important to make their home life as relaxed and stress-free as possible because they do get a lot of stresses at work. So when we go home, there's no stress in their life. It's laid back. You're a dog. Be a dog while we're here. And, you know, it's just a happy life for them. They're regular dogs. They just like to play. And when they come to work, basically everything they do is playing. They're not trying to hurt people. They just enjoy the search and the game of finding things.
Your best friend.
He's my best friend. He's a pet at home. He's my partner at work. You couldn't ask for a better partner when you come to work, and you couldn't ask for a better pet at home.
Good boy, Hickson.
It takes a lot of training to get these dogs ready for work. And that's what Hickson and Officer Gleason are doing today.
He's got you.
We're here today with Sergeant Mick McHale of the Sarasota K9 Police Force, and we're at one of your training facilities. We won't say where, but it's somewhere in Sarasota. And what are we going to see today?
Today we're going to concentrate on what is known as a building search.
K9 team trains together on a regular basis to make sure the dogs are ready for just about anything. But while apprehensions are important, these dogs still start with the basics.
So what is the first level that you put the dogs through?
The first phase of the training is basic obedience training. And what that is a foundation for everything else that we do. And we start out with teaching the dog to sit, to lay down, to stay, and to heel. Once we get a good foundation, then we can go into the other forms of training.
The state of Florida requires at least 480 hours of training before the canines begin working full-time on the force. Then it's days like this one that help keep the dogs on track.
The scenario that we set up is a bad guy has broken into a business, and we have responded to a call that the person is still inside the business.
After contacting the business owner to make sure that no one is supposed to be inside, the canine officers are required to give a warning to any potential burglars.
The canine handler will give a warning to any and all individuals who may be in this property that are not allowed or not permitted to be, and in essence are committing a burglary.
But it's the last chance that the bad guy gets before the dog gets
it. It is
the
last chance.
If the criminal surrenders, then the dog stays on the leash and helps with the arrest. But if not, then it's the dog's job to find the bad guy and make sure he doesn't get away.
Good boy, Hickson! That's a good boy, buddy!
Each of us, especially if you can imagine you're someplace you're not supposed to be. You're sweating, you're scared, you're letting off a heat source, an odor. It's a distinct odor. The dog is trained to look for that heat source. Once the dog enters into the building, and they will narrow down the heat source and where it's coming from, and eventually locate the area which the person is located. If they have the ability to enter a doorway, it's not shut, closed, or locked, then they will immediately engage the bad guy without the handler's presence. That's what they've been trained to do.
During the training, the decoys, as they're called, are instructed to yell and fight back to make the situation more real for the dogs. After each dog gets a training run, they head back to their kennel to relax and decompress from all the action.
On a track or a building search or just an apprehension, they get very worked up, so it's better to just get them back in the air conditioner and let them settle back down.
Let them just chill.
Yeah, let them just get in there, give them a nice glass, bowl of water, ice water.
And you get one too.
They get it first, though. We always take care of the dogs first.
Great.
Still ahead on Animal Outtakes.
The ability now to perform their duties with the assurance that they have an extra level of protection is something that we welcome with open arms.
A generous donation is helping keep these amazing animals safe. We'll show you. Plus, meet a dog whose nose is in high demand. The important work this girl is doing all over Florida. Later, we dive in as our training session goes offshore.
For thousands of years, we've been humans' best friend. You've been through a lot, and we've been right there with you. A dog is part of the family, a confidant, and a friend who always knows how to get into your heart. So what happens to our beloved companions when we can no longer care for them? This is why we've created Dante's Den, an innovative, state-of-the-art facility that will provide care for up to 100 dogs.
Dante's Den is a community for joyful dogs.
Millions of Americans face uncertainty when planning for the future of beloved pets who may well outlive them. Dante's Den is a charitable organization, so in whatever capacity you can, please lend your support so that we may continue this most wonderful work.
Dante and I would like to thank you for watching and for also opening up your hearts to our wonderful community of joyful dogs.
Learn about the many ways you could become involved by visiting dantesden.org.
It's that time of the year again. Time to grab the family and head out to Top Dog, a dog show like no other. Enter your pup in categories like best dressed.
And look at this.
Funniest trick.
Wow.
And more. Join the fun at
Top Dog, Saturday, October 10th at the Sarasota Municipal Auditorium. Proceeds support Dante's Den, which provides a loving, home-like setting for dogs. Visit topdogsrq.org and get your tickets today. This is our miracle puppy, Sugar. Sugar is about 6 months old now and had a terrible situation. She didn't have any toys to play with, and so she grabbed a pillow in the home that she was living in. And unfortunately, her owner did not approve and took it out on Sugar and threw Sugar against the wall, put her down on the floor, and beat her. And so she had broken ribs, a punctured lung, and a kidney that just was not working anymore. And so she was brought to one of the local veterinarians who said, I can save her. And they did. Now look at Sugar. Sugar is perfect. She has no residual effect from the fact that people were really very cruel to her. She is nothing but love, and this is why we call her Sugar. And we sing to her, Sugar, Sugar, and she loves it.
Police canines are subjected to danger every day they go to work. But thanks to a very generous donation, these dogs have a little extra protection in the form of bulletproof vests.
We feel very necessary that these poor dogs get consideration. And most of your departments all over the country do not have funds to vest the dog.
These vests were custom made and tailored to each dog's specifications to ensure a proper fit. But the dogs won't wear them full time.
Although they're lightweight, we would not expect the canine team, the canine, to wear the vest at all times. So while responding to a call of service, it would now be a tool that the canine handler could utilize to apply to his partner prior to the arrival. And even on arrival, if you had it applied full time, their ability to perform on a regular basis during their shift would be greatly diminished.
As Officer Jake Nelson demonstrates on his partner Bronson, the vests only take a few minutes to put on. They're similar of what officers wear and have the same ballistic rating as human vests. And when put into use, the addition doesn't keep the dog from performing his mission, apprehending the bad guy.
When we have calls for duty, for service, especially those where we know that there's a possibility of an armed subject, to include an edge weapon, it's an added piece of protection and equipment for our canine partners that we'll be able to utilize that we didn't have prior to this donation. Although we never equate the canine partner to a human, they are very important to us as canine handlers, and the peace of mind to know that we have this extra piece of equipment to protect our partners is greatly appreciated by the members of my unit. Let's pray to God we never have to use the vest.
Seek, 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 seek.
Where? Good girl, okay.
Misty here is a very important dog.
That's a passive, yep.
See, she's what is called an accelerant detection canine, working for the State Fire Marshal's office.
Show me. Good girl, okay.
Alongside her human partner, Detective Mike Douglas, Misty helps determine if suspicious fires were started by accident or on purpose.
As it currently stands, in probably North America, we're probably one of the busiest dog teams there are.
Really?
Yeah, we average right at 200 a year. Find it. Let's go to work.
Yes, that's 200 calls just for Misty's nose, one of the highest in the country. Together, this team will search a fire scene from top to bottom looking for evidence of arson. And they're pretty good at it, too.
I bring her in, let her come in front door, back door, depending on where I have to enter. And then when you bring them in, they have a work command. You put them in a work command, but you let them do a loose seek. And then she'll just go around sniffing and you're walking with her. If she does an alert at some point, then you pick where you want to start in the room, then you put her back down, and then now you start throwing targets for her where you want her to go.
How accurate is Misty?
They're 85 to 90%.
Wow.
There is no perfect dog. And again, a lot of that is because we're under a testing standard that the lab's under.
When fully staffed, there are 6 dogs like Misty working throughout the state. But they're not the only dogs employed by the fire marshal's office.
Good girl. Good girl, Bella. Hootie, that's a girl.
Bella, a German Shepherd mix, is also employed as an explosives detection dog.
But our duties are mainly for, right now, for special events, like the Gasparilla Parade just happened here in Tampa a few weeks ago.
Thankfully, in Bella's 3 years of service, she's never come across a live bomb in the field. But both she and Misty are required to be 100% accurate in training to receive certification. Both dogs are taught when they smell an accelerant or an ingredient in explosives to perform a passive alert.
She'll go up and she'll find the odor and she'll sit down and she'll indicate to me where the find is at.
While these dogs are on call 24/7, they know when it's quitting time.
So she does become the family dog when she goes home.
Yeah, she knows the difference between the time I get my boots on and go out to the truck when it's time to work and when she can relax at home.
Next on Animal Outtakes, these dogs have to be ready for anything, and that includes water. After the break, we make a splash with these amazing animals. It's that time of the year again. Time to grab the family and head out to Top Dog, a dog show like no other. Enter your pup in categories like best dressed.
And look at this.
Funniest trick.
Wow.
And more. Join the fun at Top Dog Saturday, October 10th at the Sarasota Municipal Auditorium. Proceeds support Dante's Den, which provides a loving, home-like setting for dogs. Visit topdogsrq.org and get your tickets today.
For me, it started with one hit of sardines. Oh, sardines. That's where I learned to beg. It was easy to score free fish. I mean, hey, with this dolphin smile, yeah, it's illegal, but no one cares. I had a monkey on my back, man. I was jonesing for people food, hanging out under boats, dodging props and hooks, and doing dangerous stuff that I'm ashamed to admit. Look, I know that I can kick this if people would just stop feeding me.
And now, it's time for
Tales from Dante's Den.
Asha is a special girl. This gorgeous Siberian husky got a second chance when Dante's Den stepped in and rescued her from a very grim fate.
She was on the euthanasia list and she was going to be put down the next day. So we went up there and we got her that day and we brought her back and that changed her life forever.
After a couple of weeks at Dante's Den, she came alive.
We gave her some special attention. We did cook for her, give her a special diet because she was very underweight. That Asha has just started to bloom and her fur started to come back. Her coat was better and she was happy.
choosing to spend her days with staff veterinarian technician Carol in the clinic.
The other dogs pretty much know where their kennels are, but Asha has taken the hospital, and the clinic is her spot. She's kind of got a special place in my heart. I hate to see dogs that have just given up hope and have given up on life. She does like to hang out over here. She's my assistant. I call her my assistant.
But this girl does know how to have fun.
She loves to go out into our pool area and run and go in the pool and swim. And she likes to just kind of play the chase me game. It gives me such a great feeling of accomplishment that, you know what, even if we just save one dog, it's one dog that's been saved, and they've been given a new lease on life.
Checks it. Watch when she hits the hot one. Oop, did you see that?
Mm-hmm.
So woo, good girl! Yeah!
Deep in the Carlton Reserve in southern Sarasota, a group of dogs is hard at work. They're training for the important role they play in helping find people who are missing or lost.
This is Sarasota K9 Search and Rescue. It's an all-volunteer search and rescue organization based in Sarasota.
Now, what we hear search and rescue. What are you looking for?
We're searching for lost people. A person that's confused, someone with Alzheimer's dementia, someone who's despondent, walks away, and they need to be found. Children that get lost. That's what our team is here for, to locate them.
Tammy Treadway is the group's training coordinator.
Now, how many dogs do you have in this group?
Right now, we have 26 dogs. They're varying levels of training. We have our puppies, a couple of those. We have a good pool of trainings that they're getting ready to test. And then we have our deployable dogs, which are ready to go.
We are part of Sarasota County Emergency Services.
Joe Abrams co-founded the group with his wife after one of their daughters was taken by a predator.
Fortunate enough to get her back. But we wanted to make sure that nobody ever had to suffer through that. So we started the search and rescue team.
How many of the bad guys have these wonderful dogs put in jail?
Oh, since our inception, we have put away approximately 20, I think it's 24 people.
How do you train those puppies? How do you get them to work?
It's a game. Basically, the whole search and rescue is a game with them. We find what they like. We look for their drive, the one where you have the tennis ball or the toy and you throw it and your arm gets tired long before they get tired. And you take that reward system and you use it and place a person with it. You give that person their toy, their ball, and they run into the woods, and then you let them go and they run after the person, and it's a big happy game.
There are several different facets to search and rescue. Tracking and trailing dogs use an article of clothing belonging to a person to track their scent. During area searches, the dogs will try and pick up on the freshest scent.
If you have a 5-year-old out laying down in the grass, you want to be able to put the dog in the air scent. The dog will get to the cone being put a V here, and the air comes by and the air scent goes out.
Yes.
The dog goes through one area and will just in the cone until it spots the person. Sadie's taught to reach the person, come back, bark twice, and bring me back in.
They have no idea they're searching for a lost person. All they know is at the end there's a big reward. Mom and Dad are really happy. Everybody's all happy.
While Florida may be known for its sunshine and beaches, there is a rainy season, and police canines have to train no matter what the weather may be. Today, the handlers with the Sarasota, Florida Police Department are working on apprehensions on the water. Living and working along the coast, these dogs have to be prepared for anything. The scenario being demonstrated today involves an unruly person on a sandbar. Officer Nick Dominus assumes the role of decoy for K9 Hickson and Officer Sean Gleason. After giving the standard warning, Officer Gleason releases Hickson, who dives into the water and pursues the suspect. Just like in other apprehensions, Hickson is trained to bite once and hold on, no matter what. Officer Dominus yells and fights back, helping to simulate what may happen during an actual apprehension. After a few more times, it's time to head back to the beach, where K9 Cody gets a chance to train.
Hello,
Officer Gleason plays the part of a bad guy, attempting to swim away from law enforcement. Cody races in after him, and just like with K-9 Hickson, grabs a hold on his man and doesn't let go until given the instruction from his partner. For these dogs, it's important to train regularly and to introduce every possible scenario so that they are prepared for whatever situation they're in, even if it's on the water in the middle of a rainstorm.
Stay with us. We'll be right back.
It's that time of the year again. Time to grab the family and head out to Top Dog, a dog show like no other. Enter your pup in categories like best dressed,
and look at this,
funniest trick,
wow,
and more. Join the fun at Top Dog Saturday, October 10th at the Sarasota Municipal Auditorium. Proceeds support Dante's Den, which provides a loving, home-like setting for dogs. Visit topdogsrq.org and get your tickets today.
Animal Outtakes is produced by Dante's Den Foundation, a nonprofit group dedicated to creating the best life for dogs. If you would like to learn more about Dante's Den, donate, or volunteer, visit our website, dantesden.org.
That's it for this episode of Animal Outtakes. We hope you've enjoyed learning all about police canines and how these amazing dogs are helping law enforcement officers all over the country. Join us again next week for another outstanding animal adventure. We'll see you then.